start to breathe. Breathe in through your nose and breathe out through your mouth. Again, just take your time, just take your time to start to lengthen the breath, make the breath a little bit longer. Your hands up now. I want you to place your hands onto your rib cage, and I want your breath to go into the ribs. So breathing in, feel the ribs expand into the hands with your breath, and then feel that rib cage gently float back in with your exhale. Inhale, expand the rib cage, and exhale, release the rib cage. Release the arms back down by your side, and now I'm going to gently start to engage with those abdominals just by very gently drawing your belly button towards your spine. Just a very slight engagement, nothing more than that. Start to bring one knee up so that it's in line with your hip, and then bring the other leg up. So both knees, this is called tabletop position. Now, because you've now lifted your knees, your back may have changed position, which is fine. Let your back settle into a new position if it needs to. Now you've gone, you may have gone into an imprint. Now your knees are lifted, relax your feet, shake out your feet a little bit. No tension at all. Keep a little connection here, relax your head, your neck, your shoulders, arms are by your side. Take a deep breath. And just tap one foot down to the floor, keep the knee bent. Starting off nice and easy, we're going to ease ourselves into this. Inhale, come back. We work with the breath. Exhale, come down. Inhale, coming up. So you're hinging at your hip and you're keeping the knee bent. One more on each side. You're going to bring the knees into tabletop. On the exhale, float both of the arms up so they're directly above your shoulders. Breathe in. One arm comes out to the side. Inhale. Other arm. Right out, gently just touching the floor. Inhale, coming back up. Knees are staying in tabletop. Back is settled. Back into tabletop, take another breath, and bring the other one into tabletop. Okay, take a deep breath in, float the arms up. So we've now got the arms up and the knees up, and we're going to start with that tap down again with the legs. Breathe in, tap down, keep the knee bent. Inhale back up, other leg. Now this time as we do the tap down, we're going to take the opposite arm out to the side. mobilizing the trunk of the body. So again, that means keeping the back in its position, keeping the belly button drawing into the spine, working with your breath. More to go. Remember, listen to your body, rest whenever you need to, hug your knees into your chest if it hurts your back, last one. And then bring it up and hug the knees to chest. Another back release, lovely stretch on the back, just hugging the knees in. And now taking those legs back into tabletop. And then again, let's place the arms back down by your side this time. And we're going to go into the single leg stretch, take a breath. And again, extend one leg away from you. Inhale, bring it back. And switch. Starting to lower the leg as you extend. Again, same thing applies with the back. Think about the breathing, you're breathing into the rib cage, so you're connecting with the core, so your breath isn't through the abdominals, it's through the ribs. Now keep going with the legs, we're going to join in this time with opposite arm, again this time going behind, up and over. So all the way up and over behind you. Slowly work the do just two more. And then again, reach for those knees and have another knee back. And legs back into tabletop. Arms by our side, we're going to come into the hundred. So when we lift the head and shoulders, we're going to extend the legs straight up in the air. Breathe in. We lift and we bring our feet together, slightly turn the feet away from each other, but the feet are touching, and we pulse the arms up and down. Inhale, exhale. Stay with me, exhale. Keep that going, you're imprinting the spine, you're drawing in nice and strong from here now, because this is quite challenging. Stay with me if you can, rest if you need to. One more breath, and then bend the knees, head and shoulders down, knees to chest. Now let's repeat that this time. We're going to come up and we're going to just extend the legs slightly further away from the body this time. Breathe in. Slightly, not too far, and off we go again. Make it a little bit more challenging. It's too difficult. Bring the legs back up so they're over the hips. Deep breaths. Remember, breathing in through the nose. Don't breathe too fast. Stay with me if you can. Rest if you need to. Hug the knees in any time. One more breath. and then hug the knees in. We've got one more of those to go, that's quite challenging. Hug the knees in. Again, I'm going to challenge you to go a little bit lower with the legs. That is only an option, okay? If you're new to Pilates, don't do that. Keep the legs up quite straight. Okay, so let's do one more of those. Breathe in. Feet together. Off we go. Lower back is staying printed into the floor. Belly button is nice and strong now, pulling right down to the spine. Breathing up here. Nearly there. Let's do one more breath. Well done. Oh, that's good. Bring the knees in. Have a little rock from side to side. And then lower the feet. Extend the legs. Breathe in, arms up and over. And we're coming back into a full body stretch. And exhale, release it there. Bring those feet back in. And then I want you to walk your feet in a little bit closer to your bottom here. Okay? Heels are closer to your bum, knees in line. We're going to move into shoulder bridge. So let's place the arms down. Try to keep the knees in alignment. Let the back settle to start. We start with a pelvic tilt. So we breathe in, push the back down. And we peel into bridge, pushing the hips up really high. Just stay here with the arms. Take a deep breath at the top of that bridge. And on the exhale, bending the spine, slowly roll all the way down. Try and imprint each bone as you come out of that bridge. Breathe in, we tilt the pelvis. On the exhale, we peel the spine off. We take a deep breath in at the top of that move. And then on the exhale, we release it. Again, breathe in, let's go here, and exhale. And this time, as you inhale, raise your arms all the way and reach them behind you. On the exhale, bring them back, wait for them to come halfway, and then lay the spine down with the arms. Okay, so you've got a nice breath in to start the move. You peel off imprinting as you come up into the bridge. Inhale as you float the arms, keeping that high bridge. Exhale, start to release the arms. Lay that spine down nice and slowly. And again. Next time we do the bridge, we're going to go with a leg lift at the same time. So if you don't know, just do a normal bridge and watch this time. Breathe in. Come up into the bridge. Now as you take your arms up and over, you're going to lift. And then you're going to lower. Keep the knee bent. And just lift the knee so it comes over the hip. The idea is to try and keep that high bridge. Let's do the other side. So we lift up. Do one more of those on each leg. Last one. Hold onto me. And then just do a few rocks more back here. momentum and rock to seated. All the way up to seated. And we're gonna sit. So again, I'm gonna extend the legs out, not too wide. If you want to sit on a, if you've got a yoga block or if you've got a rolled up towel or anything handy, if you feel uncomfortable sitting in this position, or bend your knees a little bit. Sit right on top of your sit bones. Lengthen the spine along the shoulders. We're gonna do the saw. Arms are coming out wide. You're gonna take again, arm, opposite foot, okay? So you're gonna breathe in. As you exhale, rotate and reach to the opposite foot. Inhale, lengthen and come back to center. Go over to the other side. This other arm is going behind you. Don't worry about taking your legs wide, doesn't matter. This arm goes behind you. Inhale, draw the abdominals in. The spine can't get anywhere near the foot. Two more. Last one. Back to the center. Gently release the arms, roll the shoulders, bring the legs in, and give the legs a shake down. Now bring ourselves over. We're going to come over now onto our hands and knees. So bring yourself into a box position. Place the hands, spread the fingers, shoulders over wrists, hips over knees. Push into the floor. You can bring a little bit into the mat with the fingertips, take a little pressure out of the wrists. So again, think about the back settling. Think about engaging through those abdominals just gently here. We're going to start with the Superman. So we're going to breathe in. And you're going to extend one leg, opposite arm. And then you're going to lift hip and shoulder height and stabilize here. Don't forget to breathe. So again, keep the head in line with the spine, keep it nice and strong, breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. And then on your next exhale, release that down. Just sink back for a moment into extended child's pose. You might want to shake out that supporting side, slowly your head gently to the floor. And then let's come back up, check your positioning again. We're going to do the opposite side now. So when you're ready, breathe in, extend the other leg and the other arm, and then lift it up the hip and shoulder height, make it strong. Stabilize the trunk. Into a front lying position, and when you're here, extending your arms and your legs. And we're going to go into swimming prone, so remembering again, lengthening here, drawing that navel in away from the floor, breathe in, lift opposite arm and leg, head comes up alongside, inhale, lower, lengthen as you lift. Thank you. pass, two to go. Let it go. And then bring those hands on, push up onto hands and knees, and bring yourself back into a box. Again, check placing your hands, spread the fingers, make sure the shoulders are over the wrists. We're going to finish off here with the plank or Pilates move, I hate to say, leg pull. Here we go. So lengthen one leg, lengthen the other leg. Now make sure it's a strong position. If you struggle, just drop your knees. Perfectly fine. Drop the knees if you can't hold a full plank, or hold it for as long as you can, then drop the knees. Now the head's in line with your spine. Make it strong, push into the floor, shoulders are back and down, navel to spine is strong, and breathe. the shoulders, shake it out. See if I have more life on the other side. Breathe in. With the other leg. Again, hold it. Soften that supporting knee. When you're ready, breathe in. Let's reach up with those arms. Bring the hands together. Then bring the hands to the heart. Stand up nice and tall. Don't forget to breathe. Well done.